So welcome back. So in the last video I showed you that my 6900S wasn't receiving properly. It's a duff, so it's going back. I just received a new one and stuck it in the truck. Happy days. So let's see how we get on. So I'm just going to go through the process of pulling it out of the box, plugging in a programming cable, wide-banding it, and then checking that it works. So I'll skip through the boring bits. Okay, so I've got a cable specially designed for the job, about £6 on eBay. Plugged that on to there ready. Plug the other end into the PC, which is just under the desk here. So when you first turn it on, it will say 29.5 megahertz on channel 1 on band F. On band A, it will say 28.0 megahertz. So it's going from 28.0 all the way up to 29.7 megahertz. But what we need to do is switch it over to be wide-banded, which means it will go much lower, from about 25 up to 29. So to do that, switch it off, hold down function and EMG or SRF, whatever you want to call it, and then power on. And then it will ask you what band. You can't see it because the camera's not picking it up, but it says band. Well, it says one band. If I turn the knob, it will say two band. So I can switch back from one to two. So I want it on two. Once you've selected two band, hold down, make sure you hold down the function button, and it will say RES to start with, and then you hold it, keep holding it down, and then it will say R end. Then you can let go, switch off the power, switch it back on again, and now it's in wideband mode. So now on band A, on channel 1, it says 25.615 megahertz, and it goes all the way up to 28.305 megahertz for the channels that are programmed in. Now that covers the range of the CB frequencies, which are on 27 megahertz. So what we're going to do is use a programming file that I've downloaded off the internet from the 6900N users group, and I'm going to add that. So what that will do is it will put CB radio on A, and then all of the other ones will be low, high, mid, and whatever else, I forget. That will give us channels such as 25.555, I think, will be on the D band. Sorry, 27.555 will be on the D band. It might even be on here already. It is. So yeah, so 27.555 is already on here, out the gate. Can I get like 305? Fred in the Shed's channel. Yeah, it looks like it. Now the only problem is, while it may have all of the wideband, you know, the free band frequencies, it does not have the UK FM normal CB channels anywhere. You might be able to find them by nudging around and using the clarifier, but that's no good. What we really want is to be able to go to either A or F and use the channel selector to select a channel that matches up with the UK FM frequency. So that's what we're going to do now. So it's switched on. We're on band B, band 2. Doesn't matter what, all of the settings on here doesn't matter. As long as you've rebooted it, as we've just looked at, and it's in wideband mode. We'll switch over to the screen recording, and I'll show you how it works. I've got the CB attached on the USB cable. So we need to open, so I don't need to save that, which is here. So on my downloads file, I've got this file here that I've created. Now it's the same as one that I downloaded off the SS6900 Facebook group. It's this one that I used. This one here is just my copy of it. I've added in my own personal data so that if somebody steals my rig, there's a chance that we'd know it was mine. So I'm going to select that, and what we'll see here is on band, let's see which one's the CB band. So channel 19, yeah, so this is the CB band. Now you'll notice, if you know anything about frequencies, is this has 27.885 8125. None of the other bands have that 25 on the end. They're all zero. They're all round numbers. There's an issue with this rig in that when you program in this, it's not going to read this 25. So if we stick with channel 19, all it's going to read is 27781. It won't add the 25. Bit annoying, but that's just the way it is. You have to program that in manually afterwards on the radio by turning the clarifier knob clockwise until it says 25. Just add them all up to 25 and then forget about it. Job done. So we haven't actually written this to the radio yet. We've just loaded it from my DAT file, and now I'm just going to put write to radio. So that's it. It's writing all these channels to the radio. So we're going to have UK FM on A, and then we'll have various other 27 megahertz bands on all of B, C, D, E, F. Done. Okay, that is it. So I'm going to switch off the rig now, put the cover back on, and just test it with the handheld CB radio again to make sure it's not bricked like the last one. Okay, so I've just programmed in using the cable. I've switched off the power. I'm just going to unplug this USB cable. Forget about that now. What I'm going to do is switch it back on. I'm going to select band A, channel 19, and I'm going to turn the clarifier until it says 25 on the last two little digits, because we know that's the correct frequency. So we're on FM, band A, 27.78125. Let's get the handheld and see if it picks it up still. Yes, it's working. Awesome. So we've not bricked it. Works as I would expect. The only thing I don't understand, there's a dot after the first two. I don't know why it does that. Maybe someone can tell me. But it only seems to do it on channel 19. Anyway, it works. So we'll put it in the truck and see what happens. Right, welcome back to the channel. So I've just put the new rig in the truck. The old one's over there. So I've used the microphone from the new rig just in case there's a problem with the microphone. So this is a new microphone, new rig. All the rest of the wiring's all the same. So this, I've not tested it yet. Turn the squelch down. Can't quite get the knob. Okay, so E-tone off. First knob off, whatever that does. I'm going to turn the output power right down. RF gain is right up. We're on band A, CB frequencies, FM, clarifier, 19, volume's at half. Right, so now when I key up, hopefully, we get four bars. And we do. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing, testing. Right, well, that's what should have happened about 2 days ago.